talking about India's mission to Mars. Mr. Wagle, I'll continue with you. Now, we are talking about a 450 crore rupees mission completed in a record 15 months of time. Tell us about the team behind the Mangalyaan.
Well, see, the Mars Orbiter mission or Mangalyaan is an Indian mission. It has been made by Indians. It has been put together by Indians, designed by Indians. It will be launched from India. The rocket is Indian. When it goes to Mars, it is not carrying a flag, it is not carrying a and the data will be Indian. So Indian scientists will get to see the data first. So if any results which come out would be Indian.
Right.
So it's the whole thing, the satellite itself was fabricated in the satellite center of the Indian Space Research Organization in Bangalore in 15 months, and about a team of 500 scientists did that. I interviewed the the project director for the mission, S. Arunan, and what he told me was very interesting. That for the last 15 months, he slept almost every day in the satellite center. He used to go back only to perform his puja. Scientist and puja both go together in India. We have everything tandem. We do everything right and do well. So he used to go back for his puja. His entire team also worked day and night. Same way, the rocket has also been put together very quickly. The design has been done. At the rocket port, currently, there would be about 1,000 scientists who are working hard. You and I celebrated Diwali. Those people didn't celebrate Diwali.
Right.
What were they doing? They were fabricating India's largest rocket. The rocket itself is 45 meters high.
Right.
Which is as high as a 15-story building, weighs 320 tons. What is that? That is the weight of a fully loaded 747 Boeing jumbo jet. And these 1,000 people, while we celebrated Diwali using small rockets, were preparing this large rocket for India's maiden mission to Mars. So there's a lot of sacrifice which many scientists have done.
Right.
And all of them have done one what? They have done on salaries which are really peanuts. They get very small salaries, but they devote their lifetime doing cutting edge work.
Right.
And that is the big benefit they get out of it. So it's a fascinating mission. I'm very excited about people from overseas who were involved, like they were involved in Chandrayaan.
Okay.
I would have been even more happy, because that becomes an Indian mission where India is the captain.
Right.
And there are other players.
Right.
But today it's an Indian mission where India is the captain. So as Sachin Tendulkar retires, we have another big mission coming up from India to take India into the interplanetary space.
Dr. Basu, Mr. Wagle gave us a sense of, you know, the kind of hard work and sacrifice by the entire team behind the Mangalyaan. But, you know, every time there is a launch slated to take place by ISRO, although there's a lot of excitement in the air, there's a sense of pride as well, but it also meets with a lot of criticism. Many say that India has misplaced priorities. When millions are going hungry, we should not be spending 450 crore rupees on a mission to Mars.
You see, this kind of argument makes no sense, for the simple reason. See, during the recent cyclone that we saw, 5 lakh people were moved. How could they be moved? Because we had advanced information about how the cyclone is moving, how it is behaving and all. So this, and you know, after INSAT came, our weather forecasting has really improved, and we are able to, you know, forecast many things more accurately than you have been able to do in the past. Today, for instance, remote sensing satellites, they are helping us in a big way in survey of resources and even flood control and so many other things. So space technology by itself has done a lot of good to us. Communication, for instance. Look at the DTH. So our villagers would have never experienced the joy of television if we didn't have DTH and satellites.
Right.
Because terrestrial transmitters were very limited. Even today they are very limited. And these satellites have opened up the huge external world because they don't not only get local channels, they get any channel from around the world.